Hey guys, what's going on? It's your favorite mortgage lender, Abdel Khawatmi, Paramount Residential Mortgage Group with my team, The Mortgage Plugs. Want to touch base with you guys on regards to a couple different things. The first thing mainly is the new conforming loan limits that was just increased now heading into 2022. My company has actually already adopted it, Paramount Residential Mortgage Group. The new conforming loan limits has actually increased now from $548,250 to right now increasing to $625,000. What I want to talk to us today is actually in reference to what is the difference? What does this mean in regards to a consumer who's looking to get a regular conforming loan and somebody who's looking to get a jumbo loan? So a jumbo loan is anything that exceeds the specific conforming loan limit of the area. So there are some counties in New Jersey that actually some of those conforming loan limits are actually higher for a single family unit, as high as $822,000. But if you're currently a consumer who, let's say, for example, is looking for a home in Mercer County, what actually ends up happening is what goes on is you get a mortgage, but the loan amount exceeds the conforming loan limit of, let's say, right now in 2021, $548,250. You actually cannot get a regular conforming loan. You have to go to a jumbo loan. And we're going to talk about the differences between a conforming loan and a jumbo loan. So when it comes to not just necessarily million-dollar homes, there's a few homes, especially whether it's in San Francisco, Hawaii, a lot of also Bergen County homes, or even down in Mercer County where you have Princeton and some nicer areas, you have to get what's called a jumbo loan. Even if the home you want isn't jumbo size, the value is higher. Edgewater, Hudson County, you're going to have some homes that are going to assimilate and you must get a jumbo loan. So the difference is mainly between a jumbo loan and a conventional loan. When you actually boil it down, the difference is essentially the dollar amount for the loan. There are set limits, guys, like I mentioned, for maximum counties in each county. Bergen County goes as high as 822. Other counties like Mercer County goes as high as now, heading into the new year of 2022, they just increase it to $625,000. Because the Federal Housing, FHFA, actually uses conforming loan limits as a way to maintain, and that's the key thing, they want to maintain the financial stability of the housing market within those specific counties. So if a loan actually exceeds the conforming loan limit, the borrower has to go and get a jumbo loan. So what is a jumbo loan? Some of the key traits, guys, for a jumbo loan, people want to borrow more than the conforming loan limit. They dig into it and it makes them unique. Jumbo loans aren't held to the same eligibility guidelines as conforming loans because they're not eligible to be purchased or guaranteed on the secondary market. The secondary market is Fannie Mae and Freddie Mac. They are the ones that set specific lending guidelines. Okay, now when a loan exceeds those conforming loan limits, the lender actually creates what's called a jumbo loan for that specific borrower, and the debt cannot be sold to investors, and it's actually kept within the lender's specific financial portfolio. So what do you think is going to happen? The guidelines are going to be super stringent and a lot harder for you to qualify for them. And simply put, it comes with stricter qualifying guidelines like higher credit scores, larger down payments. You need to shore more assets, more reserves, lower debt to income ratios, and also most importantly, the interest rates are actually a little bit higher because the bank is assuming the risk. Now, a conforming loan, they're the most common type of mortgage in the country because they actually follow guidelines that are assimilated and can be sold on the secondary market. Now, you'll actually see a conforming loan, again, whether you're looking to refinance or purchase, they're bought by a lender, whether it's on the secondary market through, as I mentioned, Fannie and Freddie, and pooled together through Ginnie Mae. They provide liquidity to the mortgage market. So if a lender takes your loan, chances are, in many instances, they will probably sell it to another lender in the near future. No changes to a consumer. Your mortgage payments is the same. Everything stays the same. The only difference now is that what happens instead of you paying bank A, you pay bank B. So what it does is it actually reduces the risk of lenders and it gives them the ability for everybody to conform to specific guidelines that are actually set through by Fannie Mae and Freddie Mac, such as minimum credit scores, so 620 for FHA or 580 in some instances. Debt to income is a big one. Minimum, again, credit scores, what's the max that you can borrow, compensating factors, owner occupancy, a lot of different guidelines that banks have to follow. So the less risk for lenders means they qualifying guidelines obviously are easier for consumers. And again, the difference, most mortgage lenders prefer to work with conforming loans because they're easily liquidable. You can liquid them. You can also have the ability to be able to conform them and sell them to secondary investors to free up some capital. As of January 2021, like I had said, the cap for a single unit was $548,250. It has now changed into $625,000 heading into 2022. That's huge. That's an increase of almost $75,000 that we were kind of expecting because FHFA acknowledges that prices of a home is consistently increasing. So $625,000 is what it is, the new conforming loan limits for a lot of specific counties, mainly in the state of New Jersey. You also have them in San Francisco, Los Angeles. There are some counties that actually have maximum loan limits of as high as $822,000 in the more expensive areas. And those areas actually allow you the opportunity to borrow more without having to go the jumbo route. And then when it comes to HERA, which is the Housing and Economic Recovery Act, they actually require an annual review of these conforming loan limits to make sure that they reflect the average U.S. home price. Since 2008, according to the Federal Housing Finance Agency, various legislative acts have actually been put in place to increase these loan limits, which is why we're seeing that happening now. Qualifying guidelines, again, for these conforming and jumbo loan limits. Again, it's not the cost of the home, it's actually the size of the loan, right? So it doesn't necessarily mean just how much is the house. If it's a $1 million home, but you're borrowing less than what the max conforming loan limit is, that's okay. It's based off of what you are borrowing from the home. If your home loan amount is actually less than the specified conforming loan limits, then you're good. You meet the lending criteria. If it exceeds, then you have to go with a jumbo loan. And again, the biggest thing when you go to a jumbo loan, guys, if you have a consistent, excellent credit profile, a good amount of money in your savings and steady income, then you'll probably have an easy chance qualifying for a jumbo loan as opposed to having to go becoming flexible in regards to conforming guidelines and going within those. So how do you stay within those conforming loan limits? Again, you have to stick to a budget. You want to increase your down payment to stay under that $625,000 when this year was $548,000. So at least it jumped up $75,000. And again, the biggest differences, guys, is your rates, stricter guidelines, higher interest rates, and so on and so forth. So again, seeing what kind of loans that will follow up for you, contact my team and I. We'll be more than happy to guide you and put you in the right steps and directions as to which one best works for you, and then we can go from there. If you guys have any questions, contact me directly, 201-679-0422. Thank you.